Welcome back to Tesca Technologies Private Limited. My name is Shivam Vijay and today in this video I am going to giving a brief description about installation and working of mobile thresher. Thresher is a farming machine by which farmers can separate their small grains like wheat, peas, soybeans and etc. from their shafts and straws using the threshing method. Primitively, threshing method involves beating by hands on a flail or using animal hoofs so that all the small grains can be separated by their shafts and stems. As the technology advanced, the main advantages of thresher machines are it includes less physical labor and more efficiency. That means in the lesser time we can get the more grains or seeds come out with the shafts and cutting stems. And less seed breakage is also a major advantage of using thresher machine. Also, there is one disadvantage also that if the thresher machine is not used properly, the seed breakage could be occurs more. But in the proper manner, when you are working with the thresher machine, you can get the more efficiently clear seed grains through the shaft and stems. Now, for coming in this video, we will see the complete assembling of all the parts of this thresher machine. Later on, we will see the working principle of this thresher machine and we will also observe the field working with this machine completely. So now, let us move on to the basic assembly parts of these machines. This is the front platform which will be connected to the inlet side of this machine and this is the upper cover of this front inlet. Then we have the outer side hood. This hood covers the outcoming thresher or the shaft which are thrown out from the thresher process. This will be used for stopping these coming out garbage and other shafts or stems. Then this is the output of excess cabbage while working with the seeds, the seed output coming from the back side of this thresher machine. So moving towards the main working parts of this thresher machine which are already installed, this is the pulley that is connected to the threshing drum. And directly using this V-belt, it is connected towards the motor pulley. The motor is working with the electrical power. It has a single phase 3 HP power motor and it has the MCB working over here. The single phase 2 pole MCB is also connected properly and output wires for providing input supply is going towards free with the 2.5 mm square wires so that you can easily run this motor on the electrical circuit. The motor has a capacity of 3 HP and it will take around 16 amperes on the starting while working so that you can get the proper working of the thresher machine. Motor run on the 1450 RPM approximately with working on single phase power supply. So this is the threshing drum in the main part of this machine where you can see that these teats are provided so that it can easily pull out the seeds or the grains from the shaft and stems, and as the seeds pull out there is a sieve looking like bucket. Before that a sieve is provided so that all the grains can easily collected through this bucket, and bucket is in taper position so that all the collected seeds will go out from the outlet port over here. So after you can over here put any container or box here, the seeds will be come out properly. And after that, at the upper part, the inside shafts and stems will be cut out from this section, and also the separated seeds from these excess shaft and stems will be going directly towards the outlet port of this. So after grains are coming out, now we move to the outlet port of this excess shaft cabbage. Here you can find out the excess cabbage or cutter over here. The extra cabbage or shaft will be cutted from these cutting blades. If I move this drum, you can easily see that the shaft will be cut, and using these blades, the seeds will be again go towards the, either they will go to the bucket or they will pass through this hole over here and go to the outlet port. So now let us move to the assembling of this complete machine. First, we will install this platform. At this platform, the paddy or the complete grains with the shaft is put it over here, and this section will be installed at this. Using these holes, you can easily pass through bolts provided. So inlet platform is connected. Now we move to the covering hood from the inlet side. This will be connected using these holes. Properly tighten all the bolts using the required spanners. So inlet side is completed. Now we'll move to the output hood. On the output side, this hood will be connected like this. Now this output grain shaft will be connected on this outlet box. So mainly all the parts now are being installed, completely assembled. Yeah, after that you can start working with this machine, because we have already connected V-belt and motor to the machine. I will also explain you, if you are facing some loosening about the V-belt, or you want to change the V-belt if it is not working properly, you just need to unscrew these four bolts of this motor base, and after that, losing this, you can just pull out the motor upwards, V-belt got loosened, and you can easily take out the belt from this drum. After losing and tightening the belt again properly in tight position, you can just tighten up the bolts of this motor and with this platform or these plates, so that you can easily start working with this motor. Apart from that, if you are working in any remote area where electricity supply is issue, or there is not proper electricity supply, we have also providing installing mechanism for gasoline or petrol based engine. Using these attachments, you can easily connect the gasoline based engine at the front panel, and gasoline based engine can be connected. Just pulley need to be connected to the shaft of this engine that you are going to connect it on this attachment of this mechanical arrangement. So after complete assembly of this paddy thresher, now we are ready to do the starting of this machine. For this, you have to connect this 3-pin top in a 16 ampere suitable plug for the current rating. The motor is connected is about 3 HP of power, so that it will take in the around 16 to 20 amperes at the start. Now after plugging up the machine, you just need to turn on this MCB. This is a 2-pole MCB for single phase power supply that we have connected over here. And then you start the machine, the motor will start run, the fan belt support the drum, and drum will also start rotate. Now we'll explain you the inner working of this complete mobile thresher. After placing all the paddy on this platform, the rotor drum will start rotating with the help of belt. As you can see in the drums, there are teeth are over here. This will pull out the seeds of grain from the paddy and put them to the lower bucket inside the drum chamber. When your working goes starts, after that, using this check nuts and screw, you can adjust the cutting parameter for the grains. If the brains are not cutting properly and it's are damaging, you can easily adjust the sliding of this screw with these check nuts. Both the check nuts can be easily adjusted and the drum position can be easily adjusted, and you can find out the proper cutting of the grains. And when the grains are properly start cutting, this is the outlet area from where the all shafts and cutter stems will be come out on the upper part. As we are putting the grade paddy throughout the downward, all the shafts will come out from this side. As we are putting the grains or the complete paddy towards downwards, the shafts will be coming in the upwards direction. So we have put at this hood so that it can stop for wandering over here, and it will easily collected downwards. You can also connect a collecting bag over here on this hood so that all the shafts will be collected in the bag. So over here you can see that the lower bucket is connected directly throughout this outlet port. Your grains which are threshed with this thresher machine will be come out from this outlet port. Here you can put any bucket or any of the storage carton so that all the paddy and thresh grain can be easily come out. From this opening flap you can easily find out your grains are in proper conditions or not. If you are getting the grains are not in the proper amount, you can adjust the adjustment over the drum as I suggested. The adjustment are also provided on this side as well. These are the adjustment for the drums so that you can easily adjust the paddy according to your dimension or the density. And then at this point the excess cabbage or excess thresher output can be come out from there also. So this is the complete working of this paddy thresher. As I explained, after turning on the machine you can easily collected your paddy thresher. The output of this paddy thresher is about 500 kgs per hour. So this was the complete demonstration video of installation, how to install this machine completely and assemble this machine completely. Now for seeing it the working mode, we will move to the field. There another machine, similar type of another machine with paddy thresher is working on our field. So let us move on to that for working principle. So that was the complete explanation of this paddy thresher. In this video we have seen the complete assembly of this paddy thresher. We have connected input and output parts of this complete paddy thresher, and then also we have explained the working principle of this paddy thresher. For more information about this paddy thresher and related agriculture machines, you can contact to Tesca Technologies Private Limited for all type of support. And if you like the content of this video and it is useful for you for agriculture learning purpose, you can like, subscribe and share our channel, which is Tesca Global on YouTube. That's it for this video guys, and thank you for watching this video. We will meet in the next video soon.